Hi there, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. Please remember to subscribe to the channel, click the notification so you get notified when the next video is released, and also check out the playlist for more videos to do with cosmetic surgery. Hi there everyone, so today I'm going to be talking to a lady about medical tourism. She arranges flights for clients to go to the Cancun. So hi there, please introduce yourself and just tell us a little bit about what you do.
Hi everyone, my name is Gwendolyn Stevens, most people just call me Gwen, and I am with Sojourn International, and our company does medical tourism. That's one of our focuses is medical tourism, and we basically are a licensed travel agency, and so we are able to set up doctor's appointments for you in Mexico, Cancun, South America, flights, doctor's appointments, lodging, all of that. We only work with board certified physicians and reputable hospitals and clinics because... Brilliant. We know that a lot of people are very skeptical about traveling for medical tourism. Right. And so we really make sure that all of our doctors we work with are board certified, and the hospitals are, you know, licensed medical facilities. We don't want to have any of our clients going to anywhere that is not going to take the best care of them. Yeah. It's, you know, going into surgery is scary enough. So we want to make sure we make it very smooth selling and less scary as possible for all of our clients.
So tell me, so what countries would you be arranging this like from? Is it just the US or is it anywhere in the world that you can do this?
It's anywhere in the world. I will say the majority of our clientele does come from the US and travel abroad. We do a lot of work down in Mexico and South America, booking doctors down there. We have booked doctors in Turkey. I know that's another huge medical tourism spot. And the reason people like to go abroad is one, for the cost, and two, you know, you get to have a little mini vacation prior to your procedure. So, so it's the cost is a big draw for going abroad for medical tourism.
So let's focus on the cost. So, I mean, a lot of people I've heard, you know, they want to go to Mexico because they're going to save so much money. So what kinds of savings are you talking about? Say someone was going to have a tummy tuck or something like that. What's the amount of money they might save from the US, say?
So, excellent question. And I can say firsthand experience, I actually just went and had a tummy tuck done just because I had twins 24 years ago. And I was like, you know, I always wanted to have this procedure done. And so I decided, you know what, I'm out there advertising. What better way than for me to experience it myself? I can definitely give a firsthand account. And I can say that, and my procedure, I had a tummy tuck, muscle butt repair, liposuction, and I actually had a little chin lift at the same time. But all of my procedures together cost $7,200. Now, I did not go with the cheapest surgeon, but I also didn't go with the most expensive surgeon. Yeah. I went with a surgeon that, of course, was board certified, but I went with a surgeon that I kind of connected with. Mm-hmm. And I feel like when I am connecting my clients with different doctors, I bring them about three different options as far as doctors so that they can feel a good connection, because you really want to have a good feeling about your doctor, especially when you're getting ready to have surgery. So the cost of the surgery is way less expensive when you go abroad. And also, you know, I actually stayed a month, which typically it is usually about 2 weeks when people are coming down for procedures to be done. And so we ended up staying a full month. My husband and I went down, and So we stayed a month, but the cost of living is so much less, and so that's why the procedures are so much less, because the doctors are not charging as much because the cost of living is so much less. The
Yeah.
nurses, the
That's what I
hospitals.
was going to ask you. Yeah, like what's the reason that it's so much cheaper, you know? I think a lot of people think to themselves, well, you know, if it's too cheap, it can't be good. But I suppose if the cost of living is less, their, you know, their fees are less, things like that. So that's probably one of the main reasons why.
Exactly. And we stayed at an Airbnb. You can also stay at hotels. We just chose Airbnb because that's what we prefer. But we can set people up in Airbnbs or in hotels. There's also, some doctors, they have their own clinics that you can stay afterwards in their own clinics. And what we do is we help facilitate that, but we also help with the flights, because the doctor provides the facility to have the surgery at and the aftercare for the 2 weeks after. So we just really coordinate with everybody to make sure that the process is as smooth as possible for the client traveling, because any surgery is scary, but especially when you're going abroad, you're like, oh my gosh, do they speak the same language? And of course, we have found it is best to work with surgeons that are bilingual. And so that's really the doctors we work with, just because we don't want our clients to get there and not be able to ask a question and there be the language barrier. So we have found that the doctors that we customize our work relationships with are bilingual, and that makes it more comfortable for our clients.
So you've probably done this quite a lot. Have you ever had a case where a client has gone over to have their surgery and for some reason they're not approved by the doctor? And what kind of will happen in that case if, you know, maybe if it's like a gastric band or something like that, and the doctor says, no, you're not suitable, because that's kind of something really, you know, it could happen, you know, someone maybe gained too much weight or something like that. What would happen with their money and things?
So normally, before we get to that point, we are sure that the doctor is going to be able to do the procedure. And there's a lot of video conference calls back and forth, a lot of WhatsApp calls, just back and forth, a lot of communication before they get down there. If they get down there, and for some reason nowadays it's mostly COVID that is the preventative thing that's stopping people from having procedures, they can choose to say, okay, I want a refund, and we can get the refund, or they can reschedule the surgery. Normally, doctors that we work with know that these clients have come down specifically for this. So they try and work with them to get them, within the 2 weeks. So if they test positive, because you have to have a negative test before you actually go into surgery. So they
That's
test you
right.
down there. And once you have your negative test, then they can go ahead and proceed with the surgery, because sometimes you can get tested and be positive, but you don't have any signs or symptoms. So you wait, X amount of days, and you can take another test. And if you're still negative, I mean, if you're still positive, then at that point we talk about rescheduling or refunds. But doctors, we have found, have been very accommodating in refunding and rescheduling, because, I mean, with a pandemic, there's not much you can do, but to be accommodating. So, and it's just a good business practice. So, but yeah.
That's good. So just tell me, like, if someone's had a procedure done, say, you know, they have the drains in. Some people are having their drains in for weeks. Is it always taken out before the client comes back home, or could it be left in? I mean, I know you can have it taken out by anybody else when you get home, but what would their kind of procedures be?
So when you go abroad, the doctors, of course, always like to be able to take the drains out themselves, because it's their procedure. They want to make sure that everything is healing properly. So that's the optimum best, you know, option is to have your doctor that actually did the procedure take the drains out. Mm-hmm. However, if you have to come back before your drains are out, because sometimes you are just, you're just not draining as quickly as you should be, you can definitely have your own physician remove the drains. I mean, this is scary to me, but I've talked to girls that said, I've taken my drains out myself.
That's it. I know. I'm like, sometimes there's no choice.
And I'm like, oh, I do not want to do that.
Yeah, I know.
But we do follow up with our clients to make sure that if they come back with drains still in, we actually follow up with them to make sure that they are scheduling with their own doctor, and we are communicating back with the surgeon that actually did the procedure, because we want to keep everybody, you know, in the loop. We don't want anybody to fall through the cracks and, you know, God forbid something, you know, bad happens. Yeah. But if we're all communicating, then we know that, you know, everybody's going to be safe.
Brilliant. Yeah, so just last quick question for you, just really on that kind of topic of the follow-up. So after you've had your procedure and you come back, kind of like how long would that doctor be kind of following up with you? Do they do like video follow-ups and things? Is it maybe just the standard 6 weeks, or is it longer? Or even if you had like, you know, you needed a revision or something, would it be okay like to go back?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So the standard 6 weeks, but if you have any questions or any concerns, of course, you can definitely contact your doctor back. You can come through us and we will contact the doctor. Whatever is going to make the process easier for you. It is good that when you are picking your doctor, that in the actual contract, that they are willing to come back and do revisions, because you don't want to have something happen and you're like, oh, wow, this, I have a, you know, like something that doesn't look right. And that happens. I know girls talk about, they have the little dog ears on the side, and you say, you know what, I want to really get rid of those. And so you just have that conversation with your doctor that are revisions part of the procedure. But we also help facilitate that with the doctors, because we want to make sure that, you know, the client is taken care of and asking questions that they might not think about that we do know to think about and ask.
Yeah. Brilliant. Thank you so much, Gwen, for talking to me today. I'm going to put all of your contact with details in the comments below underneath the video. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.